This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Indiana, Indian, is a U.S. state located in the Midwestern and Great Lakes regions of North America. Indiana is the 38th largest by area and the 16th most populous of the 50 United States. Its capital and largest city is Indianapolis. Indiana was admitted to the United States as the 19th U.S. state on December 11, 1816 before becoming a territory. Varying cultures of indigenous peoples and historic Native Americans inhabited Indiana for thousands of years since its founding as a territory. Settlement patterns in Indiana have reflected regional cultural segmentation present in the eastern United States. The state's northernmost tier was settled primarily by people from New England and New York, central Indiana by migrants from the mid-Atlantic states and from adjacent Ohio, and southern Indiana by settlers from the southern states, particularly Kentucky and Tennessee. Indiana has a diverse economy with a gross state product of $298. 2 History 21 Aboriginal Inhabitants 22 European Exploration and Sovereignty 23 The Frontier 24 Statehood and Settlement 25 Civil War 26 Early 20th Century 27 Modern Era 3 Geography 31 Hydrology 32 Climate 33 Time Zones 4 Indiana Counties and Statistical Areas 41 Major Cities 5 Demographics 51 Population 52 Race and Ethnicity 53 Age and Gender 54 Ancestry 55 Population Growth and Decline 551 Cities and Towns 56 Median Household Income in Indiana 57 Religion 58 Language 6 Law and Government 61 Politics 62 Military Installations 7 Economy 71 State Budget 72 Energy 8 Transportation 81 Airports 82 Highways 83 County Roads 84 Rail 85 Ports 9 Education 10 Sports 101 Professional Teams 102 Auto Racing 103 Teams and Venues 104 College Sports 11 See also 12 References 13 Bibliography 14 External Links Etymology State Sign, Interstate 65 The state's name means Land of the Indians, or simply Indian Land. It also stems from Indiana's territorial history. On May 7, 1800, the United States Congress passed legislation to divide the Northwest Territory into two areas and named the western section the Indiana Territory in 1816, when Congress passed an enabling act to begin the process of establishing statehood for Indiana. A part of this territorial land became the geographic area for the new state. A resident of Indiana is known as a Hoosier. The etymology of this word is disputed, but the leading theory, as advanced by the Indiana Historical Bureau and the Indiana Historical Society, has Hoosier originating from Virginia, the Carolinas, and Tennessee, a part of the upland south region of the United States, as a term for a backwoodsman, a rough countryman, or a country bumpkin. History main article, History of Indiana. See also, Outline of Indiana section. Settlements were becoming more permanent. The Archaic period ended at about 1500 BC, although some Archaic people lived until 700 BC afterward. The Woodland period took place in Indiana, where various new cultural attributes appeared during this period. The people created ceramics and pottery, and extended their cultivation of plants. An early Woodland period group named the Adena people had elegant burial rituals, featuring log tombs beneath earth mounds in the middle portion of the Woodland period. The Hopewell people began developing long-range trade of goods nearing the end of the stage. The people developed highly productive cultivation and adaptation of agriculture, growing such crops as corn and squash. The Woodland period ended around 1000 AD. The Mississippian culture emerged, lasting from 1000 until the 15th century, shortly before the arrival of Europeans. During this stage, the people created large urban settlements designed according to their cosmology, with large mounds and plazas defining ceremonial and public spaces. The concentrated settlements depended on the agricultural surpluses. One such complex was the Angel Mounds. They had large public areas such as plazas and platform mounds, where leaders lived or conducted rituals. Mississippian civilization collapsed in Indiana during the mid-15th century for reasons that remain unclear. The historic Native American tribes in the area at the time of European encounter spoke different languages of the Algonquian family. They included the Shawnee, Miami, and Illini. Later they were joined by refugee tribes from eastern regions including the Delaware, who settled in the White and Whitewater River Valley's Native Americans guide French explorers through Indiana, as depicted by Maurice Thompson in Stories of Indiana European Exploration and Sovereignty in 1679. The French explorer René Robert Cavalier, Sieur de La Salle, was the first European to cross into Indiana after reaching present-day South Bend at the St. Joseph River. He returned the following year to learn about the region. French Canadian fur traders soon arrived, bringing blankets, jewelry, tools, whiskey and weapons to trade for skins with the Native Americans. By 1702, Sieur Juchereau established the first trading post near Vincennes. In 1715, Sieur de Vincennes built Fort Miami at Caquianga, now Fort Wayne, Indiana. 1717, another Canadian, Picot de Beletre, built Fort Weatenon on the Wabash River, to try to control Native American trade routes from Lake Erie to the Mississippi River. In 1732, Sieur de Vincennes built a second fur trading post at Vincennes. French Canadian settlers, who had left the earlier post because of hostilities, returned in larger numbers in a period of a few years. British colonists arrived from the east and contended against the Canadians for control of the lucrative fur trade. Fighting between the French and British colonists occurred throughout the 1750s. As a result, the Native American tribes of Indiana sided with the French Canadians during the French and Indian War, also known as the Seven Years' War. With British victory in 1763, the French were forced to cede all their lands in North America east of the Mississippi River and north and west of the colonies to the British Crown. The tribes in Indiana did not give up. They destroyed Fort Weatenon and Fort Miami during Pontiac's Rebellion. The British Royal Proclamation of 1763 designated the land west of the Appalachians for Indian use, and excluded British colonists from the area, which the Crown called Indian Territory. In 1775, the American Revolutionary War began as the colonists sought more self-government and independence from the British. The majority of the fighting took place near the East Coast, but the Patriot military officer George Rogers Clark called for an army to help fight the British in the West. Clark's army won significant battles and took over Vincennes and Fort Sackville on February 25, 1779. During the war, Clark managed to cut off British troops, who were attacking the eastern colonists from the west. His success is often credited for changing the course of the American Revolutionary War. At the end of the war, through the Treaty of Paris, the British Crown ceded their claims to the land south of the Great Lakes to the newly formed United States, including American Indian lands. The frontier. In 1787, the U.S. defined present-day Indiana as part of its Northwest Territory. In 1800, Congress separated Ohio from the Northwest Territory, designating the rest of the land as the Indiana Territory. President Thomas Jefferson chose William Henry Harrison as the governor of the territory, and Vincennes was established as the capital after Michigan Territory was separated and the Illinois Territory was formed. Indiana was reduced to its current size and geography. Map showing extent of the treaty lands, starting with the Battle of Fallen Timbers in 1794 and Treaty of Greenville, 1795. Indian titles to Indiana lands were extinguished by usurpation, purchase, or war and treaty. About half the state was acquired in the St. Mary's Purchase from the Miami in 1818. Purchases weren't complete until the Treaty of Mississin was in 1826. Acquired the last of the reserved Indian lands in the Northeast. A portrait of the Indiana frontier about 1810. The frontier was defined by the Treaty of Fort Wayne in 1809, adding much of southwestern lands around Vincennes and southeastern lands adjacent to Cincinnati, to areas along the Ohio River as part of U.S. territory. Settlements were military outposts, Fort Weatenon in the northwest and Fort Miami, later Fort Wayne, in the northeast, Fort Knox and Vincennes settlement on the lower Wabash, Clarksville across from Louisville, Vivi, and Corydon along the Ohio River, the Quaker colony in Richmond on the eastern border, and Connor's Post, later Connorsville, on the east central frontier. Indianapolis wouldn't be a populated place for 15 more years, and central and northern Indiana Territory remained savage wilderness. Indian presence was waning, but still a threat to settlement. Only two counties, Clark and Dearborn in the extreme southeast, had been organized. Land titles issued out of Cincinnati were sparse. Migration was chiefly by flatboat on the Ohio River westerly, and wagon trails up the Wabash, White River valleys west and Whitewater River valleys east. In 1810, the Shawnee chief Tecumseh and his brother Tenskwatawa encouraged other tribes in the territory to resist European settlement. Tensions rose and the U.S. authorized Harrison to launch a preemptive expedition against Tecumseh's Confederacy. The U.S. gained victory at the Battle of Tippecanoe on November 7, 1811. Tecumseh was killed in 1813. at Corydon to write the Constitution, which was completed in 19 days. President James Madison approved Indiana's admission into the Union as the 19th state on December 11, 1816. In 1825, the state capital was moved from Corydon to Indianapolis. Many European immigrants went west to settle in Indiana in the early 19th century. The largest immigrant group to settle in Indiana were Germans, as well as numerous immigrants from Ireland and England. Americans who were primarily ethnically English migrated from the northern tier of New York and New England, as well as the mid-Atlantic state of Pennsylvania. The arrival of steamboats on the Ohio River in 1811, and the National Road at Richmond in 1829 greatly facilitated settlement of northern and western Indiana following statehood. The new government worked to transform Indiana from a frontier into a developed, well-populated, and thriving state, beginning significant demographic and economic changes. The state's founders initiated a program, Indiana Mammoth Internal Improvement Act, that led to the construction of roads, canals, railroads, and state-funded public schools. The plans bankrupted the state and were a financial disaster, but increased land and produce value more than fourfold in response to the crisis and in order to avert another. In 1851, a second constitution was adopted. Among its provisions were a prohibition on public debt and extension of suffrage to African Americans. Civil War. Main article, Indiana in the American Civil War. During the American Civil War, Indiana became politically influential and played an important role in the affairs of the nation as the first Western state to mobilize for the United States in the war. Indiana had soldiers participating in all of the major engagements. The state provided 126. Early 20th Century Child Laborers in Glassworks, by Lewis Hine. Indiana, August 1908. With the onset of the Industrial Revolution, Indiana industry began to grow at an accelerated rate across the northern part of the state. With industrialization, workers developed labor unions and suffrage movements arose in relation to the progress of women. The Indiana gas boom led to rapid industrialization during the late 19th. Enacted the state's first income tax on several occasions. He declared martial law to put an end to worker strikes. World War II helped lift the economy in Indiana, as the war required steel, food, and other goods that were produced in the state. Roughly 10 minorities in seeking employment beginning in 1970. A series of amendments to the state constitution were proposed with adoption. The Indiana Court of Appeals was created and the procedure of appointing justices on the courts was adjusted. The 1973 oil crisis created a recession that hurt the automotive industry in Indiana. Companies such as Delco Electronics and Delphi began a long series of downsizing that contributed to high unemployment rates in manufacturing in Anderson, Muncie, and Kokomo. The restructuring and deindustrialization trend continued until the 1980s, when the national and state economy began to diversify and recover. Geography. Main article, Geography of Indiana. Square quarter sections of farmland cover central Indiana. Rolling hills in Hoosier National Forest, located in the Indiana uplands. Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore in northwest Indiana, with a total area land and water of 36,418 square miles. 94,320. Located in the Midwestern United States, Indiana is one of eight states that make up the Great Lakes region. Indiana is bordered on the north by Michigan, on the east by Ohio, and on the west by Illinois, while Lake Michigan borders Indiana on the northwest and the Ohio River separates Indiana from Kentucky on the south. The average altitude of Indiana is about 760 feet 230. Presence of higher and hillier terminal moraines and many Kettle Lakes in some regions. In northwest Indiana, there are various sand ridges and dunes, some reaching nearly 200 feet in height. These are located along the Lake Michigan shoreline and also inland to the Kankakee River Valley. The unglaciated southern segment of the state carries a different and off-balance surface, characterized in places by profound valleys and rugged, hilly terrain, much different from the rest of the state. Here, bedrock is exposed at the surface and isn't buried in glacial till like further north because of the prevalent limestone. There are numerous caves in the area. The soil is fertile in the valleys of southern Indiana. Hydrology. See also, list of Indiana rivers, list of dams and reservoirs in Indiana, list of lakes in Indiana, and watersheds of Indiana. The Wabash River converges with the Ohio River. Major river systems in Indiana include the Whitewater, White, Blue, Wabash, St. Joseph, and Maumee Rivers. According to the Indiana Department of Natural Resources, in 2007 there were 65 rivers, streams, and creeks of environmental interest or scenic beauty, which included only a portion of an estimated 24,000 total river miles within the state. The Ohio River forms Indiana's southern border with Kentucky. The major cities of New Albany and Evansville are located on the river. The Wabash River, which is the longest free-flowing river east of the Mississippi River, is the official river of Indiana at 475 miles (764). North and south sections of the state in the middle of the winter, average high-low temperatures range from around 30. In a 2012 report, Indiana was ranked 8th in a list of the top 20 tornado-prone states based on National Weather Service data from 1950 through 2011. A 2011 report ranked South Bend 15th among the top 20 tornado-prone cities in the United States, while another report from 2011 ranked Indianapolis 8th despite its vulnerability. Indiana is not a part of Tornado Alley. Average precipitation in Indiana: January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November. Dec annum 248 septillion 227 sextillion 336 quintillion 389 quadrillion 446 trillion 419 billion 422 million 391,312 302 344 313 4149 Average daily maximum and minimum temperatures for selected cities in Indiana. Location: July degree F. July degree C, January degree F, January degree C, Indianapolis 85 66 29 19 35 20 2, minus 6 Fort Wayne 84 62 29 17 32 17 0, minus 8 Evansville 88 67 31 19 41 24 5, minus 4 South Bend 83 63 28 17 32 18 0, minus 8 Bloomington 87 65 30 18 39 21 4, minus 6 Lafayette 84 62 29 17 31 14 minus 0, minus 10 Muncie 85 64 29 18 34 19 1, minus 7 Time zones. Map of U.S. time zones with new 2006 CST and EST areas displayed, showing Indiana largely in EST. Main article: Time in Indiana. Indiana is one of 13 U.S. states that are divided into more than one time zone. Indiana's time zones have fluctuated over the past century. At present, most of the state observes Eastern Time. Six counties near Chicago and six near Evansville observe Central Time. Debate continues on the matter. Before 2006, most of Indiana did not observe daylight saving time DST. Some counties within this area, particularly Floyd, Clark, and Harrison counties near Louisville, Kentucky, and Ohio and Dearborn counties near Cincinnati, Ohio, unofficially observed DST by local custom since April 2006. The entire state observes DST. Indiana counties and statistical areas. See also, list of counties in Indiana and Indiana statistical areas. Indiana is divided into 92 counties as of 2010. The state includes 16 metropolitan and 25 micropolitan statistical areas, 117 incorporated cities, 450 towns, and several other smaller divisions and statistical areas. Marion County and Indianapolis have a consolidated city-county government. Major cities. See also, list of cities in Indiana and list of towns in Indiana. Indianapolis is the capital of Indiana and its largest city. Indiana's four largest metropolitan areas are Indianapolis, Fort Wayne, Evansville, and South Bend. The table below lists the 10 largest municipalities in the state based on the 2014 United States Census estimate. 1. Indianapolis, Marion 848,788, Evansville, South Bend. 2. Fort Wayne, Allen 258,522, 3. Evansville, Vanderburg 120,346, 4. South Bend Street, Joseph 101,190. 5. Carmel Hamilton 86,682, 6. Fishers Hamilton 86,325, 7. Bloomington Monroe 83,565, 8. Hammond Lake 78,384, 9. Gary Lake 77,909, 10. Lafayette Tippecanoe 70,654. Demographics. Population. Indiana population density map. Age and gender distribution in Indiana. Historical population census. Pop percent plus or minus 1800 2632, 1810. 24,500 28,316 percent 1820 147,178 5,002 percent 1830 343,031 1,331 percent 1840 685,866 999 percent 1850 988,416 441 percent 1860 1,350,428 66% 1870. 1,680,637 245% 1880 1,978,301 177% 1890 2,192,404 108% 1900 2,516,462 148% 1910 2,700,876 73% 1920 2,930,390 85% 1930. 3,238,503 105% 1940 3,427,796 58% 1950 3,934,224 148% 1960 4,662,498 185% 1970 5,193,669 114% 1985 490,224 57% 1990 5,544,159 10% 2006 6,080,485 97% 2010 6,483,802 66% EST 2015 6,619,680 21% Source, 1910-2010-2015 Estimate: The United States Census Bureau estimates that the population of Indiana was 6,619,680 on July 1, 2015, a 210% increase since the 2010 United States Census. The state's population density was 1810. Northwest of Sheridan, in Hamilton County, 40,149,246, 086259514 in 2005, 777% of Indiana residents lived in metropolitan counties, 165% lived in micropolitan counties and 59% lived in non-core counties. Race and ethnicity: The racial makeup of the state based on the 2011 population estimate was, 868% white American, 813% non-Hispanic white, 94% black or African American, 17% Asian, 17% biracial or multi-racial, 04% Native American, 01% Native Hawaiian and other Pacific Islanders. Hispanic or Latino of any race made up 62% of the population. The Hispanic population is Indiana's fastest growing ethnic minority. 282% of Indiana's children under the age of 1 belong to minority groups. Note: children born to white Hispanics are counted as minority group. Indiana racial breakdown of population. Racial composition 1990. 2000-2010 white 906%, 875%, 843% black, 78%, 84%, 91% Asian, 07%, 10%, 16% Native, 02%, 03%, 03%. Native Hawaiian and other Pacific Islander. Other race: 07%, 16%, 27%, 2 or more races, 12%, 20% age and gender. Based on population estimates for 2011, 66% of the state's population is under the age of 5, 245% is under the age of 18, and 132% is 65 years of age or older. From the 2010 U.S. Census demographic data for Indiana, the median age is 370. German is the largest ancestry reported in Indiana, with 227% of the population reporting that ancestry in the census. Persons citing American 120% and English ancestry 89% are also numerous, as are Irish 108% and Polish 30%. Most of those citing American ancestry are actually of English descent, but have family that has been in North America for so long, in many cases since the early colonial era, that they identify simply as American. In the 1980s census, 1,776,144 people claimed German ancestry, 1,356,135 claimed English ancestry, and 1,017,944 claimed Irish ancestry out of a total population of 4,241,975, making the state 42% German, 32% English, and 24% Irish. Population growth and decline. Population growth since 1990. In the United States, according to the 2010 census, three other cities in Indiana have a population greater than 100,000: Fort Wayne 253,617, Evansville 117,429, and South Bend 101,168. Since 2000, Fishers has seen the largest population rise amongst the state's 20. Among the United States and the District of Columbia in 2005, the median household income for Indiana residents was $43,993, nearly $498,734.